never ceases to amaze me and just how God uses her. And Lamar, Sony, thank you, brother. That was amazing. Thank you. Oh, my goodness. Thank you, God. I'm so happy to be a part of this whole testimony that my friend just birthed out. All right, so all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Christ's redemption has freed us from guilt, being justifiably free through his grace, through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Romans 3:23-24. This testimonial selection will share that no one is above God's healing grace. God can save anyone. And God, in man's eyes, we see a person that may have done horrible things, but to God, that person is worthy to be saved. Only God can save a soul from hell, and that is an awesome fact. God can save the good to the bad. It doesn't matter to God. I know that this is true for myself, and I just really want you guys to just be humbled by this next testimony. I present to you a video testimony entitled Testimonial, second, a praise dance by Praise and Motion, and third, a biblical testimony by Keontae McDonald.
Perfect man, and it takes a supernatural love to even understand that beyond the walls, behind the masking, confident smile, was a broken man trying to grow up and make life worthwhile. And I know there were times that you probably shouldn't, but I thank you always love me. And I know anyone else they probably wouldn't, so thank you for always love me. Now I know there were days I looked at myself, I felt like less of a person compared to everyone else. Too big, too small, can I exchange? And trying to make up for what I felt short, I let sin slip away. When I look in the mirror and don't like what I see, oh, I just thank you for always loving me. And I know I get mad, but you wait patiently, oh. Don't let Yeah.
righteousness, I am the accuser of them all. You see, I was born in Tarsus of Cilicia. I am a Roman citizen. I am Saul, a zealous Pharisee. You see, I took charge in persecuting Christians, and in fact, I tried to chop down this following of Christ, sever the body from the head with my axe, decapitate. Because of their belief in this man named Jesus, I condemned men and women to prison, and on my charges, they were booked. But that was only the beginning of my acts, chapter 8. You see, my only mission aimed at these Christians were to eradicate. And I was on assignment to find those like Peter, Simon, and assassinate. You see, I thought I was doing the work of God. I thought this Jesus of Nazareth was blasphemy. But it was my heart. My heart was hard as stone, and even Stephen can feel that agony. But you see, it was one day. One day I was on the road to Damascus, when I was blindsided by the sight of the Savior, who gave me a new vision like a prescription for corrective lenses. And you see, that's when everything changed. I had an encounter with the living God, and everything in my life he rearranged. He even changed my name. You see, I used to be on this high horse until he knocked me off, and as I would begin to fall, it was his mercy that caught me. And he made in me a new heart. He created a new person. So now I am Paul. There's no looking back for me. I want to run into God's promises for my life with my arms wide open and my eyes fixed on him. I want to live a superior life in Christ and do away with mediocrity. I want to be so preoccupied with Jesus that I can't even take a seat because the cross I'm carrying on my back is too evident for me to even attempt to rest break. See, I want to so close to his glory that it radiates in front of me like the warmth shining from the sun in my face with my eyes closed looking to the sky. I want to be made new, washed in his blood like the empty patterns in the sand when the tide washes away from land. I want, but my I wants aren't good enough, so I need. I need, but my I needs get me nowhere, so I must do. You see, my actions speak louder than any word I can muster towards the one who created me. So I must do. And if God can use a sinner like me for his glory to write almost two-thirds of his New Testament story,